Welcome back everyone to my series about how to make art with Desmos. Previously we've made custom colors, custom curves, and custom shapes. We've even briefly talked about music a while ago. Today, we'll make our picture come to life with movement. By adding animation to our picture, we create a whole new world of storytelling. Enough intro though, how do we make things move? It's actually really simple. Sliders. You might have been introduced to sliders by a teacher trying to introduce how different parts of a function affect how it looks by using a slider in place of where a number usually is. However, did you know that you can make this animation happen by itself by pressing this play button? Also that the animation runs at 60 FPS? That's pretty cool. Now, the whole idea of using sliders to create this continuous motion is pretty intuitive, so I'm going to explain a couple of ways that you can effectively use sliders. The first method is to make something move in a function. Let's say we made a polygon of a star by using what we learned in our previous videos, and we know that we want the star to oscillate back and forth in a sine curve. We can also find a function that tracks the star's path between, and define a variable x sub, let's say star mover, to go back and forth between a set domain. We set the star domain right under the slider. Now, where we define the polygon, just add x sub star mover to the x variable and the function to the y variable. We can also do the same thing for a point if you wanted to make, let's say, firefly move back and forth in a parabola. But speaking of points, did you know that we can also do a lot more than them? This segues into my next idea, using points. We can do so much with points like putting them into a table. Here I have a triangle defined by a table, but you'll notice that the third point is defined by the point below. You can also see that I access the x or y coordinates of the point by using p sub name of point dot x or dot y. Now I can do the same thing as before and connect the point up to a slider to create a changing shape. Another way I can use points is to connect them up with Bezier curves. In my submission to Desmos' competition with my penguin drawing, which you can learn more about in this video, I connected the tip of the penguin's tail to a point connected on a parabola, making this smooth, swinging animation. Well, it would be a tiny bit smoother if I weren't recording my screen and this graph had less detail. I also connected sliders to some points defining Bezier curves for the clouds in the sky to create subtle cloud movements which create a sort of ambient environment. This next idea is pretty creative, but something else you can do is put a slider in your defined color. We learned in my other video how to define color, but did you know that you can make a slider if you define your color in HSV? In my penguin picture, it is subtle, but I have my sun sort of beating by changing the hue value for my yellow color. This last one has to be my personal favorite, but before we continue, could you consider liking and subscribing to this channel? It helps the algorithm by recommending this video to other people, like you, who may benefit from learning this. Thanks, and back to the video. Now, one of my favorite methods is using sliders in line thickness and opacity to simulate a beating or pulsing field. I feel you can get really creative, but one thing I did is make this triangle have pulsing line thickness and opacity. I also threw in some rainbow changing color for fun. One last side note for everything is that you can manually change the speed and style of your slider if you like it to go faster but only one way, or oscillate back and forth slowly. Overall, there is so much you can do with sliders, and I encourage you to be as creative as possible and discover every niche thing you can do to make your picture come to life. If you've enjoyed this video, you may enjoy the video on my left where I explain what happens at infinity, or this video on the right where I use Desmos music to Rickroll. Have a nice rest of your day, and see you in either video.